Hello students, welcome back to the new session or new video wherein we will be discussing about the different types of methods or different methods we have for analyzing the velocity and acceleration of the given mechanisms, that is the kinematic analysis of mechanisms. Till now we have discussed about the basic prerequisites or whatever the things you need to know, okay, that is the displacement, velocity, acceleration, all these things we have discussed in the last video. Now we will move on to the original topic, okay, or the syllabus of your comm subject, that to the second module. So here first we will see which are the different methods used to analyze the velocity and acceleration of a given mechanism. So we have two methods here, one is the graphical method and the second one is the analytical method. So module 2 deals with the graphical method only. Then in the module 3, you will be learning the analytical method of analyzing velocity and acceleration of the given mechanisms. Okay, so today we will see the basic things again. Okay, what exactly is relative velocity with respect to two points, with respect to a rigid link? Okay, what is relative acceleration? All these things we learn today. So first thing, that is the graphical method, consists of again four methods or four types of analysis. First one is relative velocity method, second one is relative acceleration method, then instantaneous center method, finally Klein's construction method. So we'll go one by one. First of all, we'll learn what is relative velocity and what is relative acceleration method. We will solve problems on that, 4 to 5 problems we will solve. Then we'll move on to learn what exactly is instantaneous center, how to locate instantaneous centers on the given mechanisms, and how to find out velocity and acceleration using those instantaneous centers. Finally, we will learn very simple method, that is known as the Klein's construction, with the use of which you can draw the velocity and acceleration diagrams, and using the same relations you can find out the velocity and acceleration. Okay, analytical method you learn in the third module, of course. So first of all, let us see what exactly is relative velocity. So as you know, okay, so velocity of a point or body relative to another moving point or body, relative to another moving point or body, is normally known as relative velocity. Okay, so or else we can say, or else we have another thing, velocity of a point or body with respect to the frame or fixed link. Okay, is known as its absolute velocity, is known as its absolute velocity. But when I say two links are joined together, okay, when I say two links are joined together and they are moving, so velocity of one link will be relative to the velocity of the other. That is, velocity of a point or body relative to another moving point or body is normally known as relative velocity method. Okay, now let us say relative velocity of two bodies, relative velocities of two bodies. Okay, so let us consider a body A and body B. So velocity of body A is greater than the velocity of body B, represented by VA and VB. So absolute velocity of A is given by VA, absolute velocity of B is given by VB. Okay, so here the resultant velocity will be in the direction of VA because VA is greater than VB. So we can also find out the resultant velocities, velocity like this. Okay, so this is what I told. So obviously the direction, or okay, the resultant velocity will be in the direction of VA because VA is greater than VB. Now consider a point O. Consider a point O. Okay, draw OA to represent velocity VA. Draw OA to represent velocity VA. Okay, let us draw this for a suitable scale. Now, also draw OB, okay, parallel to BA, parallel to VB. Now draw OB parallel to VB, or mark a point B, okay, which denotes parallel line to VB. Okay, now So relative velocity of A with respect to B, relative velocity of A with respect to B can be can be written in the vector sum as BA is equal to OA minus OB, correct? BA is equal to OA minus OB. Okay, so and from the figure, okay, we can say that the relative velocity of B with respect to A, okay, is equal to VB minus VA. Relative velocity of B with respect to A is VB minus VA or OB minus OA. OB minus OA. So the resultant or the relative velocity of B with respect to A can be given as VB minus VA, and the resultant velocity of or the relative velocity of A with respect to B can be given as VA minus VB. This is with respect to two bodies, okay, absolute velocities and relative velocities of A with respect to B and B with respect to A. Now let us consider two bodies moving along inclined lines. Moving along inclined lines. So this is one body A, okay, given by VA, that is the velocity or absolute velocity VA. Then another body B, and the absolute velocity is given by VB. So both are moving along inclined lines. Both are moving along inclined lines. So now what I'll do is I'll draw a line OA representing the velocity VA. Okay, representing the velocity VA in magnitude as well as direction. Then I will draw another line, okay, inclined line OB. Okay, I will draw a line OA representing velocity VA. Then I will draw OB representing velocity VB. Now, when I join these two lines, okay, like this. So this is the relative velocity of A with respect to B. This is the relative velocity of A with respect to B. Similarly, same thing applies for the relative velocity of B with respect to A. So join these two velocities or join A and B. So find out velocity, that is the relative velocity of A with respect to B as well as B with respect to A. So what we have here is velocity VAB is equal to vector BA, velocity BA is equal to vector AB. So now let us consider a rigid link and find out the relative velocity. This is very important for solving the problems. So let us consider a link AB. Okay, it is a rigid link as B rotates with respect to A and A rotates with respect to B, let us say. Okay, or let A be a fixed point. So B is rotating with respect to A. Okay, anti-clockwise with angular velocity omega, with an angular velocity omega. So always, as I have already told you in the introduction class, that the velocity of B with respect to A acts perpendicular to the link at that instant. Acts perpendicular to the link at that instant. Okay, that is what is shown here. That is VBA drawn exactly perpendicular to the link AB. Now this is VBA. Now let us say there is a point there is a point on link AB. There is a point on link AB. Okay, let us and let us notate it as C. So how to find out the velocity of this point C on the link AB? So let us draw a line representing the link AB. Okay, so this is what, and locate the point C exactly at the distance from A or distance from B on this particular line. So this will give us the velocity of C with respect to A. Velocity of C with respect to A. So we know that velocity, that is the relative velocity of B with respect to A, is given by angular velocity in angular velocity of that link into the link length AB. So here VCA can be found out using this relation, that is VCA by VBA is equal to vector AC divided by vector AB, that is equal to omega into AC divided by omega into AB. So omega omega gets cancelled. So this equation becomes, or this relation becomes, VCA by VBA is equal to AC by AB, or distance AC by distance AB is equal to original link length, or original distance in the link AC divided by the original distance in the link VAB. So while solving the problem, you will clearly understand what exactly this relation is. So now acceleration diagram, how to draw the acceleration diagram for a given link. So this has been explained already, but anyways, I'll again discuss about this. Let us consider a link AB. B rotates with respect to A, let us see. Okay, with an angular velocity of omega and angular acceleration of alpha. Now, as I have told you, there are two components of accelerations. One is the radial component, which acts parallel to the link or towards the point of rotation, and another one, the tangential component, which acts in the direction of the velocity vector or perpendicular to the link. So as we can see here, the velocity of B with respect to A, that is VBA, acts perpendicular to the link AB, and in the same direction, the tangential component of acceleration acts, that is AT of BA. And the radial component always acts parallel to the link AB or towards the direction of point of rotation. So see here, let us consider both the components AR of BA and AT of BA. This is how we have to draw the acceleration diagram in the given problem for the given mechanism. So we have radial component acting exactly parallel to the given link. So let us denote it by A dash X dash. And denote it by AR of BA, that is B with respect to A. Now, perpendicular to the link, and perpendicular to this component AR, tangential components acts. So that is denoted by B dash X dash, and that is given by AT of BA. Now, when you join A dash to B dash, that will give you the resultant acceleration of B with respect to A. Okay, so this is how we need to analyze the acceleration for a given link. So, and there are two relations in order to find out the radial component as well as the tangential component, as discussed earlier. So radial component can be found out by using the formula omega square into the link length, whereas the tangential component can be found out by using the formula alpha into AB, or the relation alpha into AB. Alpha is the angular acceleration and AB is the link length. Okay, now again, let us say there is a link AB rotating again with alpha and omega. Okay, this is how we have to represent velocity and tangential acceleration. So this is the acceleration diagram we are going to draw. Now let us consider a point C at some distance from A or at some distance from B. So how to find out the acceleration of this particular point? In the examination or in the problems, you'll come across these types of things. So on a link, there will be a point. We need to calculate, or we need to find the, or we need to analyze the velocity with respect to that point. So what we can do, we can locate, C dash or point C on the resultant, acceleration line. And using this relation, we can easily find out the acceleration with respect to C, acceleration of C, that is A dash C dash divided by AC, A dash C dash in the acceleration diagram, distance A dash C dash in the acceleration diagram divided by the distance of AC in the link is equal to A dash B dash is equal to A dash B dash in the acceleration diagram divided by AB, the distance AB in the link, given link. So this is how we need to find out, or we can find out acceleration of a point, given point on a link. So now let us talk about the rubbing velocity at a pin joint. So this is again useful for, this can be asked in GATE or even in any other competitive examination. So what is rubbing velocity? Okay, so rubbing velocity is found out at a pin joint normally. So let us consider two links which are, the point of contact is a pin joint. The point of contact is a pin joint. Both will be rotating. Both will be having angular velocities. Let us consider link 1 with angular velocity omega 1, link 2 with angular velocity omega 2. So rubbing velocity is the algebraic sum of, the angular velocities of two links, multiplied with the radius of the pin joint, that is omega 1 plus omega 2 into r when links are moving in the opposite direction, but when the links are moving in the same direction, okay, the equation or the relation becomes omega 1 minus omega 2 into r. So rubbing velocity is the algebraic sum of the angular velocities of the given links multiplied with the radius of the pin. So when the links are moving in the same direction, omega 1 minus omega 2 into r, whereas when the links are moving in the opposite directions, omega 1 plus omega 2 into r. Okay, so as of now, this is more than enough for this video. Okay, let us make videos shorter so that you will not get bored. So we will move on to the problems from next video. We'll solve around 3 to 4 problems. One problem on a 4-bar chain, another problem on slider crank mechanism, another problem on a toggle mechanism, let us say. Okay, we will solve different problems so that we can understand how to analyze velocity and acceleration of a given mechanism using graphical method dubbed relative velocity and relative acceleration methods. Okay, we'll take up both the methods, that is relative velocity and relative acceleration, in one single problem and we'll solve. Okay, so as of now, thank you very much, students. So from next class, problems will be solved, and that will not be in the PPT, of course, because problems cannot be solved on PPT. So we will be moving to some other mode, okay, of presentation. So I'll be doing the problems on an iPad, and the same will be seen, okay, on the screen. So thank you very much, students.